Hello Capricorns, welcome to my channel Surabhi, and this is the reading for you for the last 15 days of November. And as you know, they are all general readings. They may or may not resonate with each and every one of you. They may be your energies, energies for the person or the situation you are dealing with, or maybe the mix of both. So please feel free to swap the characters according to your situation. And if the reading doesn't resonate with you, please check your moon sign, name sign, moon sign and the name sign. For the personal readings, the details are given in the description box below. So let's see what's there for Capricorns. Okay, Three of Cups, the Page of Wands, the Queen of Cups, the Ten of Swords, the Knight of Pentacles, Five of Cups, King of Cups, Sun, the Three of Swords. How come Sun in between such a reading? Page of Swords. Anyway, let's see what's there from this deck for Capricorns. Again, we have the Three of Cups. Guidance from the angels. So let's see what is there for you. Two cards. I saw this card first time also, but I had not shuffled completely, so I didn't take it, but it has shown up again. So maybe there is some message for you here. I'm taking it. So Capricorns, with the Three of Cups, the Page of Wands and the Queen of Cups, here you are having some happy times, celebrating, feeling happy with friends, family, friends rather, not family. And maybe the person concerned over here, maybe you are meeting them at a friend's place. Maybe this is also there. You are meeting this person in a friend circle, can be there. And yes, for some of you, it's a love triangle or a third party situation also, because we have two Three of Cups, and the way the reading is progressing can be a third party relationship for some of you. But anyway, for those whom it is not a third party thing, so you are having some happy time celebrating with the person concerned or with your friends, moving ahead towards this relationship with the Page of Wands. So very enthusiastic, very hopeful, taking a step forward in this relationship. But here with the Queen of Cups, what I feel is this person is just contemplating as to what to do. They have a lot of emotions, but I think this person is, one more thing I got, maybe this person is more mature than you, at least emotionally mature, if not age-wise. So this person is a wise person. With the Queen of Cups, this person is a very wise person. Can be a male or a female, that's what I got. So you are in that energetic, enthusiastic energy, but this person is a person who is thinking about it, contemplating about it. Maybe they have a lot of emotions, but still they know how to control them. They know how to control them. This is a mature person and a wise person. Maybe even there is an age gap between both of you. If not that, this person is definitely more emotionally stable and mature than you. And this person is in complete control of their emotions. Okay, and because of that, what I feel here is the Ten of Swords here we have, and the Five of Cups, the Knight of Pentacles. So what I feel here is, with the Ten of Swords and the Five of Cups, definitely there is something, because of The lack of response, and between is a knight of pentacles. So maybe love is there, but things are just not moving forward. This person is not opening up perhaps, or whatever they are showing, the whatever emotions they are showing or whatever they are opening up is too less, it's too minimal. So things are just not moving actually. The thing is this, things are not picking up pace, things are just not moving forward. It's just there, that's it. Very, very slow type of an energy, and that is why the other person is very upset and they are just feeling very, very depressed on this situation, because this person felt that this person was very hopeful. Somebody here is very hopeful, but the other person is being very, very emotionally mature and wise and is not opening up. Emotionally controlled, I should say, and is not opening up, and which is causing, and because of the slow pickup of the relationship, there is a lot of unhappiness. And then here we have the King of Cups, the Sun, and the Three of Swords. And then here we have the Page of Swords also. See, here with the King of Cups, what I am getting here is we have the Queen of Cups and the King of Cups. So maybe after this being upset and being very slow in this and seeing the progress is very slow, you also become wise enough and you take back the control of your emotions. Okay, and you try to maintain that emotional maturity also after the setback. It is a setback for you. The other person is just not opening up, is just not stepping up. That becomes it is a heartbreak only. Here we have the Three of Swords also. It is coming as a heartbreak to you. You feel devastated, shattered, upset, totally depressed, not able to focus on anything. And you regain your control and you also become emotionally stable. You also stop showing your emotions. And that is the reason that the sun is shining. Now I got it. I was wondering how come the sun is between the swords and swords. In between the Ten of Swords, Five of Cups and Three of Swords. What I feel here is that when you take back your control of emotions and behave in a mature way and in a wise way, then things start happening and giving a lot of happiness. Okay, so here you are perhaps behaving immature, kiddish, in your behavior. And once you become the King of Cups, when you behave in a mature way, then you are in the same page with the other person. And this brings happiness to this relationship. And this Three of Swords, I think, is the energy which is picking up. It's or a lingering energy of that heartbreak can be at this time also. But yes, you were heartbroken. And that is why you withdrew your emotions and that opening up and that flamboyant thing and that chirpy thing, whatever it was. And with the Page of Swords, now things start opening up and bring happiness to this relationship. Okay. And with the Three of Hearts once again, now I can say that it can be that it can be maybe since the other person was not opening up, so maybe it was actually, as I said, it can be you better this person with your friends. This is a friend of a friend type of a relationship perhaps. Can be this, and you were celebrating together and you initiated the move, but the other person wasn't in that mood. Okay, and once you withdrew it, now here, because I didn't see this card as a celebration much, I'm seeing this card more as a celebration and a happy vibe to it. Okay, here the guidance from the angels is Six of Thought. Peaceful times are on the horizon. The storms have passed and now you can see that your destination is within sight. The stress in your life will begin to fade away, allowing for happier times. It may be necessary to take a journey over water to other countries. So it's self-explanatory, peaceful times on the horizon. Whatever the tension was, it has passed. It's over and you are moving in towards this happiness. The Nine of Emotion. This is a magical time in your life when wishes are granted and dreams come true. It may seem that good luck is following you, but actually these happy times are the reward for being loving and wonderful person. Your angels are asking you to enjoy your life and have more fun. So maybe that is why what I said, have more fun. So this wasn't looking that much of a positive energy and happiness. But this card, while I completed the reading, was giving that vibe of happy times and celebrations at now. Okay, now things are okay, things are settled. That was the vibe as I went through the reading, starting from this Three of Cups to this Three of Cups. And that is what is coming as the guidance from the angels also. So let's see what is the guidance from the universe for you. Come on. Nine of Swords, Ace of Pentacles, Four of Cups. So somebody, definitely those sleepless nights, somebody here is being uninterested, not interested, but yes, there is a new beginning with the Ace of Pentacles. And just see the commitment. The Ten of Pentacles, stability, family, commitment. Okay. Three of Wands, some wait is there. Somebody has to wait over here. Somebody has to wait for the other person to respond. Page of Cups. As I say, somebody has to wait for the other person to respond. Here comes the Page of Cups. I think this is a response from the person. Okay. Think enough cards. It's okay. There's no need for so many cards also. It's the message has been conveyed beautifully, Capricorns. So anyway, that's all I have for you. Hope it helps. And please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Let's meet in the next video. Bye.